That's a really interesting question. And I'm glad you asked it because it gives us a chance to talk about what are these powders that everybody's having. When you have like astragalus powder or reishi powder or cordyceps powder, what is that? Obviously, these things are not growing in nature in powder form. So have they just taken, say, the astragalus root and put that into a grinder and ground that down into a powder, and then that goes into a bag and goes to you? Or is there something else to it? So when you start out with these herbs, astragalus, it's this long, narrow root. If you look at something else, for example, like reishi, it's obviously this beautiful red mushroom that grows on hardwood. Cordyceps is grown in crazy ways in nature, but these days it's more commonly grown via fermentation. So that's obviously not the way that you're getting it, most likely. I mean, you can buy these things in that form and do extractions with them yourself. Oh, I've just kind of given it away there, haven't I? But what happens next is the extraction step. Now, depending on the herb, depending on the plans for it, it may be going to be extracted into water or extracted into alcohol, maybe both. In the case of other things, for example, like you might think, oh, well, maybe that's not the case for pine pollen. Actually, there is other stuff that happens to pine pollen. It's not done by extraction, but it still undergoes high pressure processing to crack the cell walls, because otherwise the pine pollen is actually not going to be very bioavailable. So pine pollen is not just harvested and then consumed. For maximum bioavailability, it has to undergo cell wall cracking. So that's pine pollen. But back to the other ones. You're going to extract into water, which means it's basically, well, it's going to vary a little bit by the herb, but you're going to probably simmer it for a while, and then that's going to, you know, simmer right on the edge of boiling for probably a couple hours. And then the herb material itself, which is referred to as the mark, is then going to be removed. And then what's left, that liquid, is a water extract. You could think of it like a tea. And then that is then boiled down and boiled down and boiled down and boiled down till there's hardly anything left. And it's very concentrated. It becomes thick, thick like a syrup. And then this is now spray dried. And then it's spray dried and now it has become a powder. So that's gonna be if it's just a water extract. But maybe you're doing something a little bit different. Maybe you're dealing with an herb like reishi mushroom where you want a dual extraction. You want both the alcohol soluble components, which are the terpenes, which are the adaptogenic compounds in the mushroom. And you also wanna make sure you're getting the beta-glucans, the immunologically active compounds in there. So first, before you do the water extract, you're gonna slice the mushrooms and then they go into alcohol and they sit in there for an extended period of time and it get extracted out into the alcohol. And then once that's done, the mark, the mushroom material, is then removed and used for a water extraction. So once you've got both of those, then you combine those liquids back together, then put it through spray drying, and now you have a dual extract in powder form, which is pretty cool. So that would be the example with our reishi. Then with our reishi, of course, we like to go an extra step further always, so we do a 50-50 combination of that dual extract powder with then also the spores of reishi, which are basically like the seed of the reishi, which undergo double cell wall cracking, again, kind of similar to pine pollen, but even a little more advanced, to optimize their bioavailability so you can actually get at the goodness that's locked up inside them. So these have already been extracted. So they don't require any further extraction. You don't need to simmer them yourself as you might if you're dealing with, like let's say you were buying some raw chaga chunks or you were buying astragalus root slices. You would still need to do some stuff to it, such as simmering it for a while to make it bioavailable. When you talk about putting these in a tea bag, it's not really necessary. You don't need to go to that length because all you have to do is take the powders with you, stir them into some hot water, and bam, there you have your tea. It's instant because these are already in a totally usable form. They've already been extracted. They'll just dissolve right into the water, and it's very, very easy. Now, some of our herbs are maybe a little bit different. For example, black ginger would be one example, and blue butterfly would be another. Because of the nature of these, we process them differently. They undergo freeze drying. So that's concentrating them, usually about 6 to 1. And then you have the whole plant in there. It's not an extract, you're actually getting the full thing, but the biological nature of the ginger root and the flower are such that it doesn't really require extraction in the same way. But all the same, those can, again, be easily just stirred in with water. You don't need to put it into a tea bag. If you tried to put any of these powders into a tea bag, you'd be dipping the tea bag in there, pull it out, and you would suddenly realize, my tea bag is empty. Where did everything go? I could have sworn just a minute ago I put some stuff in there. but it's just not the right application to do that. These herbs are great for when you're traveling because you just gotta stir them in water. It's super easy. And if you want to, you know, a lot of people, myself included, when I'm traveling, I like to make a premix of different herbs. So let's say I have 4 or 5 or 6 different herbs I may be taking at the time. It's great to pre-mix those just for ease when you're gonna be traveling. That way you don't have to deal with all the different containers. You don't have to take the time to scoop out each individual one. You can pre-mix those and then you're just good to go. You do one big scoop, depending on however many different herbs you have in there and how much you normally take. And you can put those in a bit of hot water and there's your tea. You are ready to go and you're gonna have an amazing time. So have fun wherever you're going. Thanks so much for joining me today, guys. If you've enjoyed this video, if it's put a smile on your face or brought you any new information, do me a favor, leave us a like down below. It really does help us out. And go ahead and subscribe while you're down there as well. You know, that way you'll stay connected with us and we can continue to share lots of great fun and educational information with you and journey together on our path to greater health and helping ourselves and those around us.